What's going on, guys? I'm Not Spring here. Welcome back to The Quiet Place, The Road Home, or A Road Ahead. My bad. And now it's time to be quiet again.
Alex,
because the monster
how's it going?
Era.
Any progress with the
phenometer?
Phenometer. Right. You get it working?
No. You need something?
Well, I'm heading to rations. Care to join me?
No. No, thanks, Dad.
Okay. Then how about I help you with the phenometer? I'm no tech wizard, but...
Dad, no, it's not ready.
I know, Alex. I know.
How?
I'm a doctor. And your father. How far along?
He's the one that got his access to the hospital.
2 months, maybe.
Who else knows?
I told Martin before he...
Oh, Alex, you will get through this. We will all get you through this. Me, Laura.
No, Laura can't find out.
Why?
You really want to tell her I'm pregnant with her grandchild?
Laura's always at her best when she has a goal. Since Martin's death, Mark's been running things, which is bad for everyone. This could give her something to focus on. Besides her grief.
It's been 10 days.
Forgive me.
I want to try something.
Ah!
She's gonna find out whether
so I'm not
we
dead,
tell her.
Which is shocker.
Not if we leave.
Leave?
This a campsite turned into a National Guard outpost. They've got supplies.
I think
it only wants to be quiet if it's near you.
Have you actually spoken to anyone at this camp?
No, but...
So we don't even know if the National Guard is still there.
I'll find proof.
No. You need to rest.
Dad, please.
Look, I'll find proof. Tomorrow I'll look for a radio and see if I can reach someone.
And if the National Guard is at the camp?
One step at a time. All right. You shouldn't have a dead flashlight. I'll get you a battery.
No, I'll get it. Are there any nausea pills?
Antiemetics. I'm not sure. Someone broke into the medicine cabinet. Now Mark won't let anyone near it.
Okay. I'll collect what I can, so we're ready to leave once you contact the camp.
Just be careful.
Maybe I shouldn't run. Alex, I don't know what to say, but I'm here. Dad. Alex, happy 1 month anniversary. I know it's super cheesy to celebrate being together for 1 month, but in this world, I'd say 1 month's quite the accomplishment. I love you, Martin. One, I owe you waterfall retreat where you'll be able to sing as much as you want. A bunch of pictures. A second, just a second, that's all it took. Drag away, haunting look, can't turn back, what's done is done, I and I'm one who held the gun. Moments come, moments past, oh so fragile, not built to last. When I'm dreaming, I hear his cries, gone so fast, no goodbyes. I play it back inside my head, what's said, what's dead is dead. Moments come, moments past, we're so fragile, not built to last. That's a nice little poem. No one's here. A written debate between me and Martin. I wrote in blue ink, Martin in red. I didn't know what last time we'd be in my room together. So we doing this? I thought Laura forbid it. She also forbid me from dating you. That was a matter of life or death. Or I beg to differ. I don't know. The only place we haven't looked for food is the ranch. Yeah, and we haven't looked because raiders were spotted there weeks ago. But still, what's the point in sitting here scared when we could actually do some good? Okay. Yippee! Maybe we do. Mom, I love you, duh. Nothing's gonna change that, but you can't, but I need you to. But I'm asking you to do something. For me, go easy on Alex. Ever since the invasion, you've made her feel like shit. Treat her like, made her even feel worse about what happened. You think she isn't beating herself up every day? You think she isn't carrying that guilt? Because she is. This morning she said she wishes it had been her instead. You have any idea how fucked up that is? And you're acting like you wish the same thing. And that's not okay. If she hadn't taken the done what... My stupid, the thing went up. Done what she did, then what do you think would have happened to me? She saved me, and Dad made his choice, would want her to, did what he thought was... My stupid, the audio for... Ooh, all the places you wanted to go. Martin, I know you want help. It's one of the many, many things I love about you, but you need to let me handle this. My responsibility to care for everyone in this hospital, especially you. Just sit tight and I'll figure it out. Love, Mom. P.S. I wish you spent more time in your own room. Alone. You're safer that way. Can effectively immediately any communication with Laura goes through me. This is not up for discussion, Mark. Debris on the ground, broken glass, etc. It must be cleaned up immediately. Stepping on a noisy surface will alert the creatures to your location. This cannot happen, Mark. The only thing I agree with on Mark so far. What are you doing down there? Y'all are just playing cards. Imagine if you had, like, Pop It. Like the Sorry game, kind of. I don't know what it's called, but it has like that pop thing in the middle, and during this, it's the only thing you play. So you had to like silence the pop, which is impossible. Amy, baby, I know you're hungry, but you can't make noise. Have the rest of mine, okay? Mommy and Daddy will get you more soon, I promise. Who's Amy? Is that a baby? A child? Storage room. In here because it's only emergency lights. If the monster will take out any sort of like electricity for the most part, you can probably hear the buzz of a light bulb easily.
good to see you're finally up. Laura will be glad to hear it.
Creep.
Find different types of items around the world. You can store and equip them whenever you want. Use up for tools and consumables. You can also see key items useful to your progress at the top right of the screen. No. We're going back. We're going back. Before I was an idiot. We're not allowed to take a piss. Bam. I don't think smoking is the thing we should be doing right now. So many documents and stuff. I'll probably be back at the hospital multiple times and it'll unlock new things. Our copy taking stuff from the storage room and left with a strange smile. That cycle gives me the creeps. He's out of control, especially now that Laura stopped running things. One more reason to leave. Speaking of, I should finish the thermometer. Could save our skins out there. Alex, my love, I found these and decided to save them for a rainy day. Maybe it's time to give them to you. In the beginning, it was meant to be a kind of a Christmas or birthday present, but it would have meant admitting that this has become our new normal, perhaps. I'm not ready to accept this no better world. You have found a spark to overcome or survive what happened to you. And I know that you will always have an ally in me. Just be careful. I love you, baby. Dad. First page of a formidable stack. Never forget how Julie would have twisted her hair between her thumb and forefinger when she was thinking, the way she rolled her shoulders whenever she yawned, her pronunciation of espresso. Her nostrils flaring whenever I said I'd be ready in 5 minutes, her fingernails grazing my palm as she held my hand, her smile was calling me a nerd, how hard she gripped my hand while watching Alex graduate high school. When she said, I'm never doing that again, I'm giving birth to Alex. The first time she held Alex, her favorite word was dawdle. The weight of her head resting on my chest, her tirade about the taming of the shrew, the way even a bad production of Romeo and Juliet would make her cry. When she'd storm upstairs to take a breath whenever she was angry. And her only attempt was to make Alex a music-themed cake for her 10th birthday. All stupid notes looked like question marks. Her shiver when I kiss her neck. All these bearded men because they can't shape because it's too loud.
How long, Laura? What are you? How long have you known? I will not let you hurt another member of my family. Laura, wait. Enough. I won't be your prisoner.
Martin wrote this that night at the ranch. Hey, I couldn't sleep last night, so instead I pulled a list of potential baby names. It was really just ideas, so feel free to circle any that you like and cross out any you hate. What do you think our child will be like? I'd like to imagine they'll have your eyes and your chin, your smile, your hair, your creativity, and your sense of humor. As long as they don't inherit my dad's laugh, I'll be happy. Oh, who am I kidding? I'll be happy no matter what. They could be exactly like you or nothing like either of us, and it wouldn't matter. The kid's gonna get sick and tired of how much we love them. Oh, wait. Surname. What do we want to do for their surname? I'm down to combine our last names, too. So, Taylor Edwards? Edward Taylors? Or do you just want to, like, wild and squash it into Taywards? Forget I suggested that. Okay, so names I like. I included girl name, boy name, gender neutral names because, hey, good name's a good name, and at some point they might want to change their name anyway, which is cool too. Evelyn. My grandmother's name was Evelyn. I never got to meet her. She died when my mom was pregnant with me, but I've heard a lot about her, and it'd mean a lot to mom. Julia, for obvious reasons, your mom was one of the warmest people I've ever met. We'll be all in good shape if our kid has half is half as kind. Devin, name of a kid who shared a juice box with me once. Legend. Alan, a homage to my favorite writer that isn't as dorky as Edgar, or God forbid, Poe. Edgar Allan Poe. Madison, selfishly, every time our kid gets angry, I want a chance to sit the quality dad joke. Man, they really put the mad in Madison. Meave, I always like the name Maeve, Meave, and I feel like Maeve, I don't know, stupid names. I feel like sometimes it destines someone to have a fox hawk and spray paint stains on their fingertips. Anyway, that's what I got for now. Let me know which ones you like, which ones you hate, and feel free to add any suggestions below. By the time our kid actually gets here, he'll probably have considered every name under the sun, which I am more than okay with. Martin. As long as the name is not Martin, because that's a stupid name. His love letter. Song ideas. Hell above. How hell actually comes from above and not down below. Fell from the sky the day laughter died. Hook? Best friend. My dogs couldn't have survived the invasion because they wanted to protect their owners. Remained best friend until the very end. Too sad. Yes. Chance to scream. Now one thing you want to do is scream is you absolutely can't. Can only scream when I dream. Last song. Song about how the last song any human ever wrote. Narrator knows that singing it will be her death, so no one will ever get to hear the whole thing. But still wants to sing it anyway. Now I see the song is just for me. Yeah, this song is just for me. What am I doing? I'll never get to write any music for any of these stupid songs anyway. Trapped. Laura never forgave me for what I did to her family, and now she knows I'm expecting her grandchild, but locking me inside my room. I'm sorry, Martin. I know she's your mother, but I won't spend my life in prison because she can't trust me. Sorry, Maureen. What the fuck? It wants me to escape that. If I step on a single piece of glass, I'm dead. And there's so much glass right in front of me. Phenomenon. The phenomenon shows the noise Alex is making in relation to the environment around her. Be quieter than the environment. Remember, tapes, wires, wits, make up an experiment, not a professional tool. Every noise is dangerous. Try to reduce the sound as much as possible by avoiding noisy surfaces or walking slowly on them. And hittable objects such as metal barrels and cans. Try to keep everything you do under the environment level. Oh, cute little otters and stuff. Nice little family photo. I don't know who it is, but they're a drawer. Okay. What did Ken say? Because everything's fine. A couple people have left the hospital, but that's good. It means those who are actually committed to our community. Just keep resting, and I got this. I can see the Glock. Let me take it, please. I already checked every inch of the hospital for food. Even though being scorched during the fire, if I'm not going to hate myself, I need to help. If I'm going to help, I need to search the outside of the hospital. I hope you understand, Martin. Laura, I can't imagine what you're feeling. If you need anything, I'm here, and I know it's not my place to ask, but be careful with trusting Mark. All I ask. Laura, we finished insulating the private rooms and offices. This will allow people to have whisper conversations without risk being heard by the creatures. However, there is no way we can do this with the large common areas. We just don't have enough insulation and sand. This puts everyone at considerable constant risk. Even the smallest noise made in one common area could bring those creatures down on all of us. I wish I had a solution, but I don't. If you make too much sound, you'll trigger the creature that will search for you. You can understand when this happens by hearing a sound cue. So get out of there and avoid any noise until you feel the danger has gone away. Noise detection. For immersive experience, the game includes a noise detection mode, which will track every sound your microphone can capture as if it was made by Alex. When the microphone detects a noise and reproduces it in-game, a microphone icon will show it. In some sections, the microphone detection will be deactivated and it will be showed with a barred microphone icon. Enable. Okay, so it wasn't actually taking my microphone before, so I could have talked at full volume at the ranch. Good to know. You can enable noise detection mode. Yep.
I want that. I did that. It's done.
Important.
Oh my god. Huh. It's right on me.
Important. From now on, all approvals go through me. We don't have to talk. Enough supplies just to be handing out medicine to anyone who asks. We gotta be smart about it. Anyone who's been volunteering. Took one hunt. Anyone who's been cleaning. Taking up extra cleaning shifts. So these are the people we need to prioritize. This is how we survive and thrive. Mark. Face the creature. Sometimes there might be situations where you need to pass to the creature to go to your next objective. Keep your distance, don't make sound, and find a way out. Also, the video is about to end, so if it ends randomly, I'll edit some stuff out.
No. No 100 day 19 day 119. No, we ain't doing that. That is not happening. No. There is two trophies apparently called the hospital. Anyway, this video was like an hour of just recording, and I'll try to edit some stuff so that way I can get the whole hospital in. By the looks of it, you get a trophy for just because I got two. I'm assuming I get one trophy for doing it and the other trophy for doing it with my microphone on. Or with, like, I bet you what I could do. I could mute my microphone. I could just have it muted. Pause, hit the mute button. Because that sound right there would 110% trigger it, because that will too. But for now, that's going to be it for this episode, guys. If you did enjoy, like, comment, subscribe, and the notification button to do that video. This is such a weird series for me to record, because I want to use the thing, because it, like, it adds so much to it. But also, commentary? So I can't commentate on things if he's right in front of me. And I'm, like, looking at him. Anyway, have a good night.